Bellwether has returned to cruising speed. Orion fighters have been deployed.
So it begins. If we lose this battle, we lose all of VCD's main force. Even if that were not the case, all the crystals lying dormant on Earth awaken simultaneously.
We'll begin a descent onto the mother. Numerous contaminated weapons and burning satellites. Proceed with caution.
I respect you. However, there's no time to take a detour. We must wipe out any enemy forces that obscure our path as we descend. What an advanced civilization. But could it be that it's the planet itself that is contaminated? This must mean that what we had thought was their mother planet was in fact an already contaminated planet.
Is this the future of Earth? Is life this planet?
We're here to prevent that from happening. Destroy the enemy.
Yes, sir. Wait, what is this? There's something odd. It appears to be a planet which once sustained life, but the atmosphere seems to consist almost completely of carbon dioxide with some...
Do you really think this is the appropriate time for a science blast?
My apologies, but I feel as if I've seen this atmospheric composition ratio from you. Captain, I'm reading an ultra-high energy signal deep beneath the surface. It's unlike anything we've come across before. There's a high probability that this is...
Must be a power. Extend the range of our radar and search the surface for leaking energy.
Understood. In the area ahead, there is a position of energy leaking from that ground. I will deploy all Raiden fighters to that range.
Well done. Did you hear that, Raiden? Looks like we'll have to head underground and destroy them directly. Set course to the objective point immediately.
Raiden has been successful in prison.
Alright. The rest of the Raiden fighters and the Bellwether are forced to the air. It will be disadvantageous to fight separately. Gather around the Bellwether and lend each other support.
CO2 at 95.82%, N2 at 2.7%, argon at 1.6%, oxygen at 0.13%.
Shuria, focus on the battle, Raiden. We can investigate the atmospheric composition of the Arctic Tentac.
Yes, I'm sorry. But I think that combination is not really good.
Your enemy distraction rate is amazing. A brilliant military achievement for a final battle.
Affirmative. Raiden has reached the gate.
Glad to. Remember, folks, we're here to fight, not to get ourselves killed.
Well, it's one thing that civilization is progressing, but all these machines are killing us. Personally, I need a view of the ocean.
Remember now, Captain. CO2 at 95.42%, N2 at 2.7%, argon at 1.2%, oxygen at 0.13%. It's Mars!
This atmospheric composition is exactly the same as Mars!
Same as Mars? Is that so? Although I fail to see exactly how that is important.
There is water on Earth, and none on Mars. That is said to be the reason why there's only life on Earth, but apparently there was water underneath Mars' surface. Why is there no water?
Who knows? I'm not a scientist, so I haven't got a clue.
What is that going to happen? If there was first water underneath?
If for some reason life disappeared, water disappeared, and the oxygen disappeared from the atmosphere. Are you saying that was caused by the crystal?
I thought it was odd when we first met this planet. Regardless of the contamination caused by the crystals, in order to destroy all life forms on the planet, it took 2 months.
I see. So what you're suggesting is that the crystals buried on Earth were not meant to contaminate the planet, but were buried to change the atmosphere itself. So you mean it could change the planet itself?
But what would be the crystals' motive for doing that? You mean to say they aren't trying to invade Earth?
What an impressive response to be for a first time battle in outer space. This is a battle worthy of a peace.
I understand you're nervous, but your response speed is lagging behind. Try a little harder.
Ishiria, can you analyze the ingredients of the crystals around life?
I'll try. The crystals here are made mostly out of hydrogen and oxygen. In other words, they're close to condensed water.
So what's being made here is different from the contaminating crystals after all.
If water is present, then more than half of the CO2 in the atmosphere would dissolve into water. There is a chance that the same thing that happened in the early stages of Earth created the ocean.
So, after turning the entire planet into an uninhabitable planet like Mars, we can transform it back into a planet where life can live.
So the crystals are trying to reset the planet?
It looks like this is more than a simple matter of a space invasion by an extraterrestrial life.
Can we build beings who act on a scale like this? These are beings who control the planets!
That doesn't mean we can just give up. Besides, I've already planned my schedule for my vacation.
Not good to analyze things more than it's necessary. We're military. All we require to do is do our best to complete our mission.
Well, that's a whole other direction to take. A far outcry from our scientific discussion.
Are they the same civilization? Or a different civilization of crystals? Although I'm not entirely sure they even have the concept of civilization.
The magnetic field surrounding Raiden is turning into something like a storm. This radar communication will be severed.
Raiden, hear us? Spock, what's going on?
We've lost communication. However, Raiden still remains, so it is likely that the storm.
What consider cheap answers, like them being the wake-up call, revenge upon mankind.
Not exactly ready to see eating, drinking, and being married anytime soon. There's no way I'm not returning to Earth and seeing the Big Blue Sea again.
There's nothing we can do now. But to pray that Raiden returns to the torches.
Raiden, I don't know if you can hear me. Get back here.
surrounding energy signals have all stopped. All enemies who had been engaged with Raiden fighters have stopped moving.
Could it be that they've really managed to succeed? Breathtaking.
Incoming transmission from Raiden. Mission complete. Returning to base.
All I can say is, well done. They really pulled it off.